Hey everybody, David Pegler here. Look at the European market for August 8th, 2012. Quick admin note: got an FX Street webinar going on today, being Wednesday at 1500 GMT. Go to fxstreet.com. Hope to see you guys there. 45-minute thing. I'm going to be talking about using time of day. It's a I've done this webinar before, but it's it bears out repeating. Sort of looking at time of day as it relates to support and resistance, and then trying to tie it all in together to project where you're going for the day. All right. So, anyway, what I'd like to talk about today is the Aussie dollar. I see a few opportunities around, and like I mentioned before, I'll update my Twitter as things change at Forex David. But let's take a look at this Aussie, and we'll break it down from. What I'm looking at here, here's your daily chart, all right. And if we just zoom out, it's pretty apparent that we running into a very significant level here, and it's a wide zone. I will concede that, all right. This 106 level has been pretty tough stuff, and we've actually nicknamed one of our members, Eric, nicknamed this Aussie Teflon, because it's so tough lately. The Aussie has been the most resilient pair as far as the dollar weakness trade going, and you know, we've been speculating on, oh well, it's due for a pullback, and as with all trends, they tend to run. So the question now is, are we going to get this move back? All right, and I think it boils down to this. If I show this daily chart, obviously we're at the top of the range. I think a lot of people have been watching that. Admittedly, the 5-EMA here, which is a means of dynamic support, has kind of risen up to meet price, but ultimately we're still hitting this resistance. All right, and I'm not sure that I necessarily believe that we're going to roll over here and come back down to the bottom of the range. And I think the Aussie is just too tough for that right now, frankly. But I do think that we are due for a move back to about the sort of 104.60, 104.70 level, and then we're going to challenge the top again. So there's something like that, a little bit of a speed up almost. All right, so that's my basic bias here. Also notice that in, what, 3 or 4 days, unable to break. You know, 1 test, 2 test, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, unable to break this level, all right? And sometimes trading boils down to the logic of, well, if it can't go up, it's going to go down. All right, I just switched to a weekly chart. And the other thing here is, notice where this 5-EMA is dynamically. It's right around that 104.60 area. All right, so big gap there too between price and the dynamic support. So I thought, given that information, the Aussie is probably an easier short than it is a buy, frankly, up at these levels, going to the 4-hour. And then the stochastics also pointed to the downside in the trade zone to the short side. So I'm not necessarily advocating shorting right here. This is definitely coming off a good support zone at around 105.50. All right, but you got your daily central today at 105.68, and you have weekly M3, which isn't the best area, but you get a weekly M3 at 105.74. So what I'm thinking here is looking for a short somewhere around sort of 105.75, and then looking to trade that down to about 104.60 for the day. All right. Also notice the little hourly change of trend here in terms of the lower lows and lower highs. All right. And the nice thing about this is, yes, the Aussie has been strong. Yes, it's still in a daily uptrend. But you know what? This opportunity is really a very low risk trade, isn't it? You know, if we write here, you make, if we're wrong here, you're going to lose 20 pips. If we're right, you make 100. All right, so it's really sort of a 5-to-1 type of trade plan, which is pretty nice. And I would expect it to do sort of something like this. You know, come down to this 105.36, bounce up to almost where it came from, and then finish the job. And I would look for buyers around the mid 104s. All right, And that's my little trade plan. That's my little trade plan on the Aussie dollar today. If you have any questions or comments or thoughts otherwise, you can email me at david@fxbootcamp.com. You can post remarks to the YouTube site. Otherwise, or reach me on Twitter, whatever. Otherwise, I look forward to seeing you in class and at FX Street for my monthly webinar. All right, take it easy, everybody. Thanks.